fucking Anthony!
What about Anthony?
He was wearing a fucking wire!
That is a problem.
My personal bodyguard wearing a wire! I raised that kid like he was my own! I beat him like he was my own son! When my son killed himself, Anthony became my son! Now this! The world is a cunt!
Where is Anthony?
I heard he's wearing a wire! So I freak out! I call him up! He's such a moron, he leaves his cell phone on! So we speak. After he's gone states, of course. I mean, Jesus. What a chump! He freaks out on the phone, and I put the fear of God in him. I think maybe I've talked him out of it. Then, he has a goddamn heart attack on the phone. I'm thinking problem solved. He's dying right in front of my ears. But the asshole lived, and now he's in the Leftwood Hospital under heavy guard!
Okay, okay.
Of course he's got you on the fucking tape, too!
Of course.
So you'll do this for me.
So you want me to talk to him?
I want you to whack him! And after that, I want you to kill all the other rats I surround myself
okay.
with!
Okay, okay. Don't worry.
It's harmony, melody, rhythm. When you have pure sound, in 10 yards, turn left.
Oh, that's not
then
cool.
Immediately left. You have arrived.
You're not like the other surgeons here. You don't have that, you know, God complex thingy.
I guess it's my bedside manner.
John, you're terrible.
Anyone flatlines from here in, it's someone else's problem.
Have a good night, Dr. Rosen. Cops act all nice when they get shot, but it's Mr. Tough Guy now that they're down the hall with a witness.
He's not looking too good, Doc.
I need a little doctor-patient confidentiality.
I wanted to stretch my legs anyway.
Boss? Peg, is that you? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Shit, Nico. You here to see the boss? He's just this way. Wait, isn't the boss in jail? What are you here for? Shit. I didn't have a choice. They were gonna put me away for some hard time.
Strap up, sucker! God damn it! Everyone, take it! I've got it!
Stupid rat!
Everybody get out of here! Police!
Hey guys,
everyone
cover
down!
Me.
This is gonna end! Yeah,
you shot me!
Screw you!
LCPD! It's just gone.
Oh, I'm hit!
Hold it right there!
We got you from every angle!
This is Eagle. I have confirmation on chicken shit.
Everyone get down!
Be afraid, friend!
Police! I told you not to mess
We've
with me!
We've lost the car!
dispatch 5 units from Leftwood.
Watch out!
Some of you will hear bad news.
No.
All of you will hear the truth.
Well, the guys at work think it's ridiculous because I listen to your show. We'll be installing sheetrock and they'll be like, turn that dingy bitch off.
The guys, there's three of them, isn't there?
No.
It will be your password. I want you to enter an altered state tonight, and all will begin to come into focus. Go to a biker bar. Take some ecstasy, and...
I don't think you will be seeing Anthony on the windmill.
I'm gonna have to see you, fucking...
I'm gonna ask about my baby and the...
Oh, I'm sorry. The spirit world is growing dark. Child of the night, or running in a nocturnal circle, or even if men are around you in a circle like now, remember, I can read minds. I know you want to call me. The price is irrelevant.
What is the price of knowing the future? Of understanding the past?
Hey, Kev!
We're going to gift.
Thanks a lot.
Blessings to
We sell quality weapons, and we know how to use them. Stay safe. Stay Second Amendment.
Mister!
I believe in the miracle of merchandising. I'll need a furry talking sidekick to spew one-liners while I chop off heads.
Don't lose your
I want
your
to go to Grenadine.
Thank you very much.
4-hour journey.
I've got a quest. I must defeat evil in some way.
Hey.
Yeah, so, anyway, a friend of mine in here tells me that a close friend of yours, girl you've been spending a lot of time with recently, swept a clean off her feet.
Okay.
Yeah, her old boyfriend wants her back.
They always do.
Desperately and quickly, and he's looking for her. I think you and her should go out on a glamorous date in Algonquin. Show her a new pad. Then, things will be okay between you two. But move your fucking ass, pal.
Women don't like a chump. You get me?
We're going to Franklin's. That's great.
You're moving over to Bowling Street.
Not in the cab of this car, I'm not. After last time, she can ride in the trunk.
Fair enough. Bitch just bit me. I think she has something to say.
Motherfuckers, when my daddy finds you, he's gonna kill you. He's gonna kill everybody you've
ever met. Get you around
me, thanks a lot.
Turn us up. And we'll turn you on. And then play commercials for the pages.
Sending us closer to third world status.
The steroid scandal continues. The Liberty Swingers yesterday announced the resignation of taking enough steroids to play ball properly. Fans agreed with the decision.
But when does technology go too far?
Sorry, guys. We're keeping this bitch.
Some wondered if you would soon be able to make love to yourself and what the moral implications would be. Leading to researcher Dr. Young.
You fucking
announced that doppelganger sex is okay, since it is with yourself.
I've always fantasized about my perfect abs and tight buttocks. And now that I've made an identical clone of myself, it is not...
Nico, my man. Katie's taking over on my duty, so I'll be watching this Guido bitch for you. Where is she?
In the trunk. She don't play too nice up front.
Gracie, Gracie, act nice now.
You motherfuckers all rip your cocks off! Help! Help me! Let me out of here!
She's a wild one. I'll try to calm her down. See you later, Nico.
Krasenberg and them booty cutters, I'd do something special with that.
He's taking the medication. Sorry, lady.
Help!
Damn, Don. What's wrong with you, man?
Shit be happening out here, man. Niggas don't be
problem with these guys that can't even think straight. So he's always there.
I run you over like a truck and leave you dead this week. I see his car.
He should be heading over to a chop shop in Coamo. Don't get too comfortable with him, Nico. Like every rat, he's a survivor. He's got good instinct. He has a bad feeling about you in particular. He bought some protection and he ain't gonna hang around and wait for you know what to happen. Then again, I'll get his chump muscle to stop for gas out of the way. It might create a good opportunity for you.
That's what I'm called on the street. Looking out and cheap, but really it be. You see, I'm street wise. A corn day, bro. Kicking the bummy shit. Just want to really over.
Turn left.
Yes,
please proceed.
Homicide Central, East New York, with a manic, depressive psycho murderer storm.
The meeting went to plan, Mr. Pegorino.
They didn't have the tough job, Bellicon. I don't got much left in mind. It's so clean. I'll talk to you soon.
Stupid people very discreetly. Okay? Now I don't know if it's something in the water or the lack of separate water fountains, but it's like a plague has taken over. I mean, I've had it with the homosexual agenda. No, thank you. Leave us the hell alone. And with that, we're out of time. We'll see you next time on the Richard Bastian Show.
Sounds a murder.
But why, Sherry?
The question is not why, Andrews, but why not?
The Science of Crime is back for another season. We've taken the fun out of cop shows and turned it into meticulous and scientific analysis. The Science of Crime is forensically boring.
Weasel News.
A murder in a hospital. Anthony Corrado, a state's witness in a major crime sting, was murdered at the West Dyke Memorial Hospital in Alderney. Mr. Corrado was down to testify in the DA's case against Alderney businessman Jimmy Pegorino. Mr. Pegorino is believed to be the head of a crime ring operating on the Alderney side of the West River.
An update on the alcoholic airline incident. The air soul pilot who shouted things like kamikaze and look no hands as he was coming into land at Francis International Airport has issued an official apology to passengers. I was just trying to impress the air hostesses and may have got a little carried away, said the disgraced father of two. He went on to say, I'll never mix my spirits again.
Meanwhile, in transport news, with traffic so bad and taxis still incredibly expensive, some urban planners are asking the unaskable. Should we reclose the bridges?
We're all about conflict resolution in here, pal. You treat her right, she'll see you through a shitstorm.
It takes money to play the game right. If you run out of money, you run out of justice and straight into therapy.
In this court, I am the law. I'm Judge Graydon. And this is Just or Unjust.
The scripted drama of a court show.
But I'm the mother of his son.
That doesn't mean he can't get some on the side.
The injustice of an American courtroom.
Somebody give me head and I'll waive the charge.
The tension of a desperate network trying to stave off its own self-imposed death rattle by making a mockery of our justice system.
But he put me in a wheelchair, and I've got to save the world in the next half hour, including commercials.
I'm tired of your fake sob stories. How am I supposed to believe you lost your legs? Now wheel on out of here, Lieutenant, before I push you down the stairs myself.
All packed together with the incredible excitement of a game show.
Okay, you have 10 seconds to tell the truth, or you'll be set on fire.
Hey.
Yeah? What's wrong?
There's good news and there's bad news. Good news is, everything's coming together. Bad news, ain't gonna make a blind bit of difference to me.
What do you mean? Do you want me to spell it out? No, I guess not.
Thanks. Packy will give you a call and explain. The ex-boyfriend of your girl is going to agree to the divorce terms. Unfortunately, turns out he wasn't our only problem. Some other crap has turned up. I don't think I'll be getting out anytime soon.
Been a great laugh.
You look after yourself.
Yeah.
Off of Frankfurt Avenue in Northwood. Looks like our joyful time with her is coming to an end.
That's a fucking tragedy. We should throw her a goodbye party.
That's the plan. Hopefully someone might bring a big present for us to this shindig as well. Maybe a big bag of diamonds will help us get over the pain of losing her. We're waiting for you, man.
I'm not a stalker, Your Honor. Not after my last conviction. I'm just trying to get some information. These are fact-finding missions.
What kind of information?
Like she's screwing so I can kill him.
You see, Your Honor? He's psychotic. He's... Hey! What are you touching? Why are you touching my hair?
It sure is lovely. So tell me, Mr. Davis, what did you do then?
Well, I was really mad about my truck, so I went to my quiet place after my yoga class, meditated, deep breathing, and then I kinda accidentally beat all the windows out of a car with a baseball bat, peed in the front seat, slashed the tires, and took a dump in the air filter.
You shit in the air filter? Give it up, my man. That's cold.
Yeah, so every time she turns on the air conditioner, her car smells like my shit.
That's right. That's right. That's ingenuity right there. That's what got us out of the primordial soup and into luxury condos with plasma TVs and robotic dogs. Good going. I like your style. Shakespeare's plays? Answer me. You can't. And you are gonna have to go through life as the weaker sex. I mean, tell me, girl, did you deserve all this?
No. I mean, he's got a good job, and I had his child.
You two have a baby?
Yes, Your Honor, we did, but I tried to do the right thing and push her down the stairs, like you recommended on one of your shows. But she had it anyway. Then I tried to sell it on the internet.
Good deal. Miss Allen?
He acted like he isn't the father. I had to do everything on my own. I didn't sleep for 6 months.
You're a terrible mother. I can tell by listening to you.
But I love my son.
When I met her, I was 24. She said she was 23, but she was really 13.
No, I didn't. I told you I was 13.
Well, it sounded like
it. You told me it was okay because you were from South Carolina.
How do I know it's my baby anyhow?
The DNA test says so.
What is DNA? I've never seen it, and I'm an accountant. How are you going to believe in something you can't see? I can't see the well.
Ain't that the truth? I ain't never seen DNA or stem cells.
That ain't cool.
I'm gonna have to retire to my quarters and think about this.
Judge Grady has taken Miss Allen back to his quarters to discuss his decision. Let's talk to a few people in the courtroom audience. Sir, what do you think? Who's in the right here?
He really has a lot of explaining to do. He pushed her down the stairs. That's no way to get rid of a girlfriend.
And what about you, ma'am?
I'm gonna try that thing with the air filter.
We'll be back after this on Just or Unjust.
WKTT. Because I love my country, and if you don't, fuck you.
Hey, man.
All right, Nico. The exchange is over on Charge Island at the water treatment plant.
Judge Grady is back in the courtroom with his decision.
Okay. All right.
Becky, my man. How are you and Gracie getting on?
Like a house on fire, ain't that right, Gracie? See, she was just telling me how much she loved me. What do you think of Nico, Gracie?
I'm fucking with the both of you!
Gracie, watch your mouth. Nico's a good friend of mine, don't say that about him.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you!
Gracie, you're sweet. I know, I'm too good for him, but sometimes a guy has got to hang out with lowlifes like Nico here. He's got his uses.
I'm gonna let you fucking use us!
That's right, he is definitely a bad influence on me.
I'm a fucker!
Okay, we haven't had this one in a while. Both of you, step into the cage. Okay, on the floor. You will find a sword, a mace, a flail, a hammer, and two tridents. Choose your weapons. Okay. Now, are you ready?
Yes.
Release the lions.
Hey. What the fuck? Let's fucking get there.
That'll teach you to screw with the man's truck. Damn! That lion ripped off her arm.
Dumb bitch, that's what you get.
Oh, he's coming after you, Mr. Davis. Nice. By the throat. That's what you get for hooking up with a young girl and stalking her in the supermarket. Let this be a lesson to you all. Two wrongs don't make a right. Damn, I love justice. What did we learn today? We learned that passion can be your undoing. That sensationalist shows like this, celebrity worship, ignoring politics, it feels good. Like I just wake up each morning and wrap my big hands around the American dream and
this
choke
is the way to do it, Nico.
Now, studio audience, when the line is
please
done, you guys can go in and eat the rest.
Let's see what our studio audience thinks. Sir, was that justice?
Sure was. I mean, man, when a couple don't get on, rather than a messy separation, what Judge Grady gave us today was two people being messily separated by lions. That shit was dope.
And you, madam?
You have a rod.
Wow, I knew it. Tastes just like chicken.
Great.
Just or unjust.
See you next time on Just or Unjust.
Gracie, you all right?
Daddy?
The bastard didn't hurt you, did they?
She can't speak. We got a gag in her mouth.
Give her back, you animals. She suffered enough.
Hand over the stuff.
Hand over Gracie. I'm here for you, sweetie.
Hand over the fucking stuff.
All right, calm down, both of you.
Oye, we put the ice in the middle, we walk back.
Then, you send over the girl. We leave, and you pick up the stuff. Entiende?
Sure. Show us the goods.
Come back to me, honey.
Let her go.
Nika Bellic. How is it? That whenever something is stolen from me, you are not far away.
I have never stolen anything from you, Mr. Bulgarin.
This man, the big Pedic, and his Dominican beach, they stole my diamonds. And you have been trying to rob the thieves, to rob me. Kanchai!
What you did to that man, but we ain't leaving here without them diamonds.
All right, I think I know who's got the ice. Follow me.
Nico, we fucking got him. Fuck, Nico, there's some guys up there.
Die, you stink!
Get in cover! Over here, Nico boy. Let's split up. I'll take the high road and you take the low road. Fuck me, a whole load of them are keep on me! Give us that fucking ice! You're trapped!
We'll let you go if you give them up!
I'm screwed either way. If I don't give you the diamonds, you kill me here and you take them. I do give you the diamonds, Mr. Bulgarin kills me later. I don't nobody having them. Screw all of you.
Llévenlo esto.
You selfish piece of cock-sucking shit. Shit, I don't want to spend another minute in this crap hole. Let's get out of here. Jesus Christ, why did that moron have to throw the ice away? It was just plain selfish.
There's always one who ruins it for everybody else in the class.
You're telling me? We would have let him live. He could have walked away from there. Instead, he's fucked, and the diamonds are who knows where.
A lot of people are going to be upset about that.
My brother Gerald is going to be one of them people. There ain't much that can cheer him up now that he thinks he's doing serious time. But this is really going to piss him off. It's going to be a nice thing to mull over. You know, while he's staring at them metal bars for the next decade or so.
A guy like Jerry can still do stuff in the joint. He organized this kidnapping shit, didn't he? Can't be the only card he's got to play.
Fuck, he wasn't too chipper the last time I spoke to him, and he's gonna be a long way from chipper when I tell him what went down. If I can get what went on straight in my head in the first place, that is. Okay, so we exchanged Gracie for some diamonds that Ray used to have. Then some Russian turns up saying they're his, then everything goes to shit. That's about right, isn't it?
There's nothing right about this situation. But that would be an accurate description of what went down. The Russian, who's called Ray Bogdanov. I worked for him on the Adriatic. He thought I stole from him and he came after me. I had to leave Europe because of him.
And they were his diamonds?
I don't know about that. They're nobody's now. The only thing that makes me smile about this shit is that Bulgarin does not have the ice. Piece of shit does not even stay at the fight to see the outcome. Just leaves his boys to clear up.
We was outnumbered,